Hey fans, I'm your host Jana, and welcome back to Dashboard by Monolith. Last week, we got you caught up on a bunch of tech news and sorted through a little bit of drama. So make sure you click here to see last week's episode. This week, we're all about evolving VR exploration, and well, stick around till the end and you'll see. So let's fire up the dashboard. RIP Oculus Go. 2 years after the introduction of this standalone set, Oculus has announced a sunset for its production. Since that announcement, both Facebook and virtual movie theater giant Big Screen have commented to discontinue the use of this product by late 2020. Some fans are left feeling that it's a little too soon to see the Oculus Go go. This unit was known for optimizing conventional materials like silicone, but not at the expense of a quality experience. Still, with a large active user base, it will be interesting to see what Oculus has as a replacement for the Go. If you're ready to suit up like our favorite genius billionaire playboy philanthropist, then you're ready for the Iron Man VR. This game, exclusively for PSVR, launched July 3rd, and the hype was on overdrive. Designers allow players to customize their suits and weapons, from not only a functional, but also an aesthetic one. Players can tinker with their suits to be as extra as Tony with 8 to 10 hours of AAA VR. Comment below for your game-changing mods. As most of you can agree, I look forward to the summer sunshine all year round. NASA has brought the sun to us with a 10-year time-lapse video which took 20 million gigabytes of data, including 425 million high-resolution photos. Now, there's no dynamic plot twist that some would expect in the one-hour compilation, but it is mesmerizing, and only 250 of the 2.5 million viewers deemed it worthy of a thumbs down. Since this astrology on steroids project started in 2010, NASA astrophotographers only incurred 1 week-long blackout in 2016 due to service system interruptions. I may have been a bit too optimistic about SpaceX's launch schedule in June. If you don't know what I'm talking about, tune into episode 1 of Dashboard, video link is here. SpaceX has a ludicrous launch schedule to keep on top of, considering they have already built 600 satellites for low Earth orbit. However, last week saw delays for a Starlink satellite aboard a Falcon 9 rocket due to neither weather nor technical errors. The team stated they simply needed additional time to complete their pre-launch checks. Fair enough. Still, their production capabilities and turnaround times are shocking. I mean, it does take a few satellites to be able to provide global internet, so consistency is key. Check the links below for regular launch updates. Internet giant ByteDance, owners of the beloved and hated mobile app TikTok, recently announced the creation of TikTok for Business. This boosts their platform for marketing and advertisements and helps them level up to competitor Snapchat. This change will use AR features to brand effects and specialize hashtag challenges. There is generally a no TikTok at work rule, and now TikTok is work. You can find me on TikTok as well as Instagram at jana.lith. What social media platforms do you use for work? Snapchat, TikTok, or others? Let me know in the comments below. Last week on our channel, we announced another Code Red winner, this time for a brand new Apple iPhone SE Product Red Edition. In order to stay in the loop about promotions, contests, and giveaways, like our videos and subscribe to our channel. We've also introduced Monovlog, a segment that gets fans in touch with our team and projects here at Monolith. Our first video was behind the scenes of our YouTube channel set build. Watch the space transform in the video right here. All right, that's it for me today. I'll see you all next week for Dashboard. Until then, check us out on social media and our website at monolithgroup.ca. I'm Jana, this is Dashboard, and we'll see you here next week.